I would like to introduce a few special people that are here. First, I would like to introduce Kyle Clements, who is the general manager of Fountain Automall and Fountain Acura, and he's going to welcome you.
Thank you. I know how much, but I wrote it down because I would forget. First, I just want to thank everybody for coming tonight and celebrating our grand reopening with us. It's an exciting time to be an Acura dealer. As you can see by evidence of the products in Florida, brand new NSX, 2019 RDX. If you haven't had a chance to look at it, the doors are wide open, please feel free. I won't get long-winded, but I just want to say, none of this would be possible without the employees here. The sales staff and the service staff, this building, our success is a direct reflection upon their hard work. So, I personally, want to thank you. I appreciate everything you do for us. And, I'm sure I echo, Jeff and Clay will, echo my sentiments. So I won't get long-winded. Again, thanks for coming. I appreciate it. And please enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Good evening. Thank you for coming to our Acura grand reopening. We are so proud of this place. We're very excited that you all came to join us. Thank you so much for coming. And I want to just talk about the process of how we got from 3 years ago, before we did the renovations, to here. It was about 3 years ago that the folks from Acura came to us with a proposal and an idea about a new image that they were working on. We were one of the first dealerships to sign up in the country, and we wanted to significantly upgrade the facility in the showroom and in service that would help us have a better place for our luxury brand, for our client experience. And so when we decided to do it, it took 3 years of hard work and determination, and as you can see, the result is fantastic, right? So I would like to thank a few of the people that were responsible for the fantastic result that we have here. Mr. Knapp, would you mind coming over here? I want to introduce Doug Knapp from Acura. And Doug is the dealer development and market rep manager for Acura in the zone that we're in. And Doug, without your guidance and advice and help and assistance and patience, we wouldn't have gotten here. I just want to thank you so much for your help. We appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
We also have another Doug from Acura, Doug Royer, who is our district service manager. Doug, great. Thank you very much for your support. Appreciate it very much. Give him a round of applause, please. Doug does so much for us. It helps us take good care of our clients and service. We appreciate you. And we also have Tamika. Where's Tamika? She just stepped out from Acura Financial Services. She's the one that helps us with the financing and leasing of the vehicles. Appreciate her being here as well. Also would like to recognize a few of the subcontractors that helped actually build this place. We have Vance and Carlton from Wamco Interiors. Where are you guys at? Thank you so much. And we have Chris from Zorn. Where are you at, Chris? Chris takes care of a lot of the things that are very difficult to get done, like paving and site work and a lot of other things that I really don't understand, but I'm not in the construction business. So thank you, Chris. I would like to give special recognition to our architect, Mr. Boyd Bundy. Boyd, would you come up here? Boyd, nothing starts on a project like this until you get the architect and the drawings and the plans. And we couldn't have had somebody to work with that is more knowledgeable, more patient, and knows how to get things done like you do. We really appreciate you, Boyd. Thank you so much. We have a plaque for you right here. It says, Boyd Bundy, we are grateful for your efforts and skill in designing and completing the renovation, and thank you from Clay, Jeff, Kyle, and the entire team at Fountain. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
He's amazing.
He is the best. If you need any architect work, you can't have him because we're keeping him too busy. Sorry. So once we get the drawings and the plans from the architect, we then need to work with our contractor to actually manage the whole process, manage the subcontractors, manage everything that has to do with this project. And where is Rob? We have the pleasure of working with Rob McMurtry and his father, Fred McMurtry, and their firm. And let me tell you, there's so many details that have to be managed. We introduced a couple of the subcontractors, there's probably 40 of them in total. And there's a lot to manage, and you guys do a great job. Thank you so much for keeping on schedule. We appreciate you. Enjoy working with you. And we have a plaque for you as well. It says essentially the same thing, so I won't read it again. Thank you. Thank you, Rob. And say thanks to your dad for us. He couldn't be here tonight. And there's one more member of the team with the McMurtry family. His name is Juan Pash. Everybody's clapping because if anybody spent more time and effort on this project in the world, it had to be Juan. And you know, managing every little detail. Juan went through this place with a fine-tooth comb and made sure it was perfect. Juan met with every single inspector over and over again from the county to make them happy, which is not an easy thing, as I'm sure you all know. And he did this all. His family lives down in South Florida, and he basically lived up here for the whole time this project was going on, which is quite a long time. We really appreciate you. Great effort. It was a pleasure to work with you. Thank you so much. We have a plaque for you, too. And I also want to recognize, we have the team from Pinnacle Advertising. Where are you guys? Pinnacle handles the Advertising Association for the Accurate Dealers in Central Florida, and we're part of that. And you guys do a great job getting our message out there. And thank you so much for coming tonight. We really appreciate it. Pete, Misha, Stacy, Taj, and the train, and Mark. Thank you so much for coming. We appreciate you guys. And I want to give a huge thank you to Brittany and DP, the lady in red dress and her lucky husband, DP, putting this event together, handling our advertising here at the dealership level. You do a great job for us. Really appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. And now I would like to turn the microphone over to Mr. Clay King, the owner and dealer principal of this organization. Clay, you're on.
Well, good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Ah, yes. It's such a joy to be here with each and every one of you. Thank you for joining us for this very special celebration. It's a dedication of the new and the greatest and the most beautiful design, so I need this for sure, that Acura, a Motor Company of America, has asked its dealers to implement to better serve its customers. And so we're delighted. It brings us great joy to look. I'm not much of a ceiling guy, but I met our ceiling subcontractor tonight, and I had to tell him he's the Van Gogh of ceiling installations. Look up there, how beautiful that is. You know, great job, you know, and every little detail really was made possible through our architect, our our builder and Juan, you know, for making sure every little thing was super perfect. So thank you all very much. And of course, we've already mentioned Doug Knapp, who's with our ACRA organization. He's the superior of all the architectural designs and developments of this region. And Doug, thank you so much. The Lord is crashing down thunder for you tonight. You know, for I'm glad we have lighting protectors up there, right? You know. Anyway, we wanted to let all of you know, we wanted to share with you, especially our customers, what our corporate, you know, what our mission is, what we're trying to do, what we're trying to accomplish. And it's really simple, and that is to deliver outstanding customer service. That's what we're here for, right? And the reason we want to do that is so that you, in your hearts, when you leave here, the Lord is speaking. In your hearts, when you leave here, we really would like that you to have that feeling to want to come back. And also to go out into your neighborhoods when the person looks at that car and starts to walk around and say, "Well, that's beautiful." He says, "Oh, you gotta go over to Fountain Acura. They're the best." You know, that's what we want, that's what we come to work to do, is to try to deliver an experience to you all. So that you want to come back to us and tell your friends and relatives to come here too, right? But how do you do that? That sounds, you know, everybody has like a mission statement, right? How do you do that? Well, we have processes. You know, we meet, and hopefully not too many meetings, you know, but we meet and we try to think of ways, like the Japanese talk about Kaizen, to continuously improve our business. Now, we look at the operational aspects every month on productivity, CSI, customer satisfaction. We want to know, we want to measure that. And believe me, all of our pay plans here are measured on how well we do for you. You know, so we want to do the very best we can to make sure you're completely satisfied, that you're enthusiastic about being here and coming to do business with us. So thank you so much for your business. We sincerely appreciate it. We really appreciate you, and we appreciate you putting up with this muss and dust and aggravation and inconvenience during this last year when we had to be over in that little building over there, and you know, it wasn't very convenient, but I think it'll be worth it for you, and our hope is that this beautiful facility, but most importantly the people that within it, will give you great joy when you come to here to visit for many years to come. So most people in the business like us know that the success of our business really comes from the team. And we have an outstanding team here at Fountain Acura. I'd like for all the team members that are associated with Fountain Acura to raise your hands up high like this.
Let's all say together, hooray! Hooray!
Thank God it's over, right? Oh gosh. But thank you. You know, those team members that just raised their hand went way beyond the call of duty, you know, overcome every obstacle that could potentially be involved, and work together as a team with great communication and cooperation to make this all possible. And now we're here to celebrate, so that's great. So thank you. I'd like to recognize three of those members of the team, and then I'm over. I'm not going to talk forever here, I promise. But one of the members of the team is our general manager, Mr. Kyle Clements. You heard from him earlier this evening. I'd like to bring Kyle up. Kyle, come up. Stand next to me, please, sir. So Kyle has been with us for a total of 10 years, and he started out as a car salesperson and worked into the F&I department, finance and insurance, then became a sales manager, then became a general sales manager, and then became a general manager. So we like to recognize one of the things, one of our critical
supporting statements to our mission is to make sure we recognize our people. We're doing an outstanding job. Kyle, wherever he has gone, has done an outstanding job. Improvements have been made time and time again under his leadership. We're extremely proud of him. When we had the opportunity to promote him last September to be general manager, of course, he jumped at the opportunity, deserved it, earned it. And so for during this past year, while you had to deal with these obstacles, you know, we want to thank Kyle not only for providing great leadership and management to our team, but for overcoming, helping us as a team to overcome all those obstacles. Let's give it up for Kyle here, right? Another gentleman who, total number of years with us, 26 years. He started out, for those of you who have been around as customers for ours for a long, long time, we used to be located on Sand Lake Road, and he started, it's John Sanborn here. Where's John? There's John. Come on up, John. Give it up for John. So, John, where did John start? Well, John started, he was washing cars, okay, over 26 years ago at our Sand Lake Road property. And we were just talking this evening. He went in, they asked him to go into the parts department, and the parts manager had a little problem, didn't do his job, and we had to let the parts manager go. And so they went to John, said, "Who do you know, John, that might be a good parts manager?" He said, "Well, what about me?" So they promoted him. And since that time, he's come over, been the parts director here, taking over the responsibility of the body shop, then taking over the responsibility of the entire fixed operations, the service parts in the body shop. John is an outstanding individual, a man of great character. He's one of the few people that also knew my dad when my dad was the dealer principal here. I'm a third generation car dealer. My grandfather started the business in 1937 as an Oldsmobile dealer. And by the way, my son is here. Where's my son? He's the fourth generation, so he's coming up in the business. But we're here to recognize John and talk about John. And John, you know, the details, the devil's in the details, as you all know, when in a construction job. And John helped so many things and thought of things that we didn't think of, you know. And, you know, he's like bringing up stuff. "Hey, you know, what about this and what about that?" I said, "Well, what about that?" He says, "Well, I think we should do it this way." I said, "Well, that sounds like a good way to do it, right?" So thank you, John, for your constant support, your advice and counsel, for thinking of things ahead of time, and being a strong, creative leader and making this place hum as a fixed operations director. So let's give it up for John Sanborn. And, of course, last but not least, the president. You heard from him just a minute ago. Let me bring him up, Mr. Jeff Gale. Come on up, Jeff. Jeff, fortunately for me, he's a lot smarter than I am and does things more efficiently than I do. And he, when there's a list that needs to be done, he can execute that list so beautifully. So he was in charge of the entire planning, developing, coordinating, and then finally executing everything that needed to be done in the reconstruction of this facility. And believe me, to do that, along with being the president and managing all of our dealership, other dealership operations, is a huge job. And without him, we wouldn't be here tonight, right? Because he made this happen. I wrote the checks, but he really, you know, made sure the checks were written appropriately, so to speak, and managed every part of the operation. So we're very proud of Jeff's leadership. Our company has never done better in its 80-year history than under his leadership. And so we're very fortunate as a company to have Mr. Jeff Gale lead it, guided and directed. So, Jeff, Let's give it up for Jeff Gale. What do you say? So now we're going to propose a toast. It's going to be a short toast. Everybody raise their glasses up. And we shall propose a toast. Maybe it'll thunder again while I'm saying this. May God bless each and every one of you in here in this room tonight with peace and joy and love all the days of your life. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much for coming.
Let's drink it better.
Cheers.